Here.
Oh, hey, I have a stupid question.
Okay.
So let's say you have...
See if I come up with a stupid answer.
All right. I bet you can. more complicated doors. He has his mad scientist shit down.
Yeah.
He does. All right, my stupid question is, if you just don't like wasting time doing the lockpicking bullshit, can you have your experienced lockpickers pick a novice lock?
Yeah.
Okay.
They'll be able to do it very easily.
You don't lose anything in doing that?
Well, you lose the opportunity to get some experience.
Okay, so you do get XP.
Yes. When you succeed in picking a lock, you get experience.
Okay, so all right. So that's the...
Oh, that was a quick trip to the next one.
Here.
Okay, so now I understand why you do your own XP and shit. The thing is, the bad thing is, I know you've played this before,
yeah.
So I assume when you just walk past something, you know that it's not something we can interact with. But there was a thing on the wall that was like kind of glowy, and I wondered whether you can interact with it.
It's the opposite side of...
Oh, I'm clearly an idiot. Okay, sorry. 100%. Ada really likes us. Are you sure we can't have sex with her?
Looks like one of those trapdoor things.
It does look like one of the trapdoor things. No, seriously, have you tried to have sex with Ada?
No, I have not.
We need to try. She likes us a lot, man. She likes us a lot.
Well, when we find a bed, we'll see what happens.
Yay! Did they?
I saw one through that window over there before he started talking. Is it gonna come to us? Yep, it is.
Oh, Ada. Yeah.
Okay. Because once it commits, we can get in a good shot on it.
That was a beautiful thing. It's really still not nearly as fun, though, because the robots just don't...
Whoa!
Spatter blood and...
Yeah.
I mean, parts okay. come off, I, but it's not quite as satisfying.
They don't scream. And
they don't scream. You don't see severed limbs. The blood spatter is my favorite. And when you get good blood spatter and you turn the camera around and you look at yourself and you're good and you're just good and marked with the blood of your enemies.
Yeah.
That's my favorite.
Okay, you got those. Oh, do you want to see if we can do anything with Ada?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, let's definitely loot first. Are Assaultron legs no good?
She's already got them.
Oh, okay. So she's an Assaultron?
Well,
no, we already put them on her.
We already put them on
already.
Her. Yeah.
Okay, I remember.
But we did have the sentry head. If we want to see if there's anything we can do with that.
Yes, I
want
to do the sentry head.
Okay.
People, if you wonder why I forget things so easily, there is at least a week in between all of these sessions, and I drink a lot of wine while I'm here. So.
Okay, so the Saltron head, 63 damage resistance, 19 energy resistance.
Okay.
And it has I'm assuming that it doesn't have any real effect on our other fighting attributes at the moment.
Okay. Sentry? Oh.
Well, we would have to add... We couldn't build one, but we already have one. It's not far off, so if we added armor onto it, because it doesn't come with armor.
Oh, she has armor on her assault helmet?
Yeah, if... come on.
Okay.
I thought she had armor on her assault.
Yeah, no, see.
Yeah, head factory armor. So she has armor on her Assaultron head.
Okay, but when you go to Assaultron head, is that saying what it has with the armor, or
I think just by itself?
Because all things equal, the Assaultron head is better.
It would be 6319 if we could. Ooh, we could put that.
Holy motherfuck!
We can put the Deathclaw helmet on her.
Let's do that. That is badass. This just seems interesting. Look at her! I love it! Oh my god, it is so awesome right now.
Okay, we have to save now.
Okay.
Good now job. That we've done that. Okay. Yeah, there's some kind of explosive gas there. Let's move away. Yeah, it's all the way down in here. Ada, come back here. Ada, come on. Thank you.
Ah. you just answered the question I was about to ask.
Yes, you can get rid of the gas. Caution, hazardous material. Those appear to be broken nuclear reactors. Is there anything in there? I don't see anything, but do you feel like it's worth exploring in there for loot?
Oh, you know that I'm always tempted to go loot everything. However... How much, like, Rad-X, how much right away Rad-X do we have? We got 24 and 24. Okay. If you want to tell me whether I'm right or not, you can. Or you can just let me make a mistake or not, or whatever.
Let's go for it.
So, well, I have a question for you, though. Uh-huh. I don't know, because of my lack of experience with the game, I don't know whether something being in an area where you have trouble, like radiation, mm-hmm. means there's better stuff there.
It often does, but you can't be sure because game writers are mean.
Okay, just like Dungeon Masters.
Yes.
All right, I want to take a chance. I want to go see what's in there.
Nothing there. Shotgun shell.
Did you get... Yeah. Stimpak. Get the Stimpak. We might need that.
A terminal.
Oh, shit. That's going to take time.
Actually, time stops when you're in a terminal.
What?
Time does not pass while you're in a terminal.
Holy shit. I'm glad that's not the...
It also doesn't pass while you're picking a lock.
Oh. I'm glad time passes when I'm at a terminal at work. That would suck ass. Okay. Well, let's read it all.
Log 077.
Nice. All right. Should I read these aloud, maybe, for our audience?
Sure.
After talking to Sharply during my smoke break, I thought of a way to turn my isolation into an advantage. I've got a buddy in the civilian service who works for a vending company, and he reckons that I can make a few bucks if I stick one of his cigarette machines down here. It would save everyone a trip all the way to the surface if they're out of smokes, and give me an excuse to say hi to some of the ladies that happen to wander in to purchase some. I'll tell you, Sharply's a goddamn genius. I might even have to comp him a few free packs for his help. I took all the trouble to sneak that machine into my substation just to have Banks over at Substation B start complaining about the smoke. At first, I thought he was just jealous that all the ladies had been hanging around my new cigarette machine during their smoke breaks. Then he showed all his cards when he told me he's going to lodge a formal complaint with Delano if I don't make him happy. He just doesn't care about the smoke. I'm sorry. He doesn't care about the smoke. Sneaky little thief just wants to cut off the cigarette sales. I might have to pay him off to keep the brass off my back. Okay, that's fun. I like reading.
Okay.
Finally got official approval to keep the cigarette machine in my substation. I'm pretty sure the free cartons that found their way into the general's desk may have had something to do with it. Now, Banks can't do a damn thing about it, and he isn't getting a single penny. Looks like this electrical engineer just came out on top for once. Well, that was useless.
Anything else in here?
It was fun to read, though.
Ball peen hammer.
You know, I love my ball peen hammers, but we have like five.
Okay, let's get out of the radiation.
Yeah, that's probably good.
The robot workbench has enormous potential. Not even Jackson managed to discover all the possible permutations.
Wait, what did she just say?
That the robot workbench that we used to modify her has a lot of potential.
Oh.
And that the guy who built her didn't even discover all the possibilities. I don't like the look of that.
What?
Right there.
Oh. Oh.
Looks like a robot lying there. Which might just be, you know, waiting for us to get close enough.
You didn't even ask me if I wanted you to take the whiskey.
I know you want the whiskey.
I always want the whiskey.
With the toothpaste or the toothbrush?
Yeah, take a toothpaste. Toothbrush in your eye.
Yep, something woke up. That was a trap.
The toothpaste? The toothpaste set off the trap?
Maybe so. I don't know. but I knew the robot was a trap. I'll take your robot repair kit so we can fix Ada with it later. Antifreeze bottle. They're hard to come by.
Oh. That is Lady expressing her dissatisfaction that I'm not petting her. Stop licking me! No.
You're in my house, woman.
I am in your house. Consent is important, though. I do not consent to the lickings.
You want a basketball?
No. Yes, I want a basketball.
Okay.
Shut up, Ada. You don't know. You don't know me. You do not know my life.
Power armor workstation. I'm not going that way. Oh, that looks large and suspicious.
That is a good time to quick save. Agreed. And we're really close to our target, apparently. To our objective, pardon me.
It's 80 meters away.
So, there is going to be a big scary thing. Rad X is worn off.
We climb up on this stuff and get an advantage by doing so. Well, that's kind of weird. Aha!
That is so satisfying.
Oh, don't fall down in there. Okay, that's just Ada.
Nope.
Are you a live robot? Yes, you are. Let's make you a dead robot.
You make it seem so easy, and it would be...
Okay, take him.
Take him.
Yep, We did make a pretty badass robot.
We did. She's pretty magnificent. The fuck was I just saying?
I make it look easy.
Oh, yeah. Can you imagine how ridiculous it would be if I were trying to...
Well, I've only played the game through about 5 times.
Well, that's why this is fun for me, though, because if I were having to use those controls and just, like, struggle with learning and getting the muscle memory to, you know, push all the buttons and know what button is what, this wouldn't be fun. I mean, that's why I haven't taken the time to do that, is because it's the learning process for this particular type of thing is not fun for me. Yeah. But the games are... I love the storytelling in the games. I'm really, really impressed with so many games that are out right now. I sound like a smug jerk. I don't mean to.
I'm not sure if Ada can decide whether she wants to be in front of us or behind us.
I'll take her either way.
Do you want all that stuff?
This particular episode is not for small children. I want Wonder Glue and the scalpel and silver. Okay. I don't think we need the wrench. Okay. What did Ada just say?
I didn't even catch it.
It doesn't matter. Yeah, the ammo box. We can do that.
It was pretty close to there, though. Just a little further.
Nice.
We have a...
More reading! The more I drink, the more fun my reading's gonna be, by the way, y'all. Unit tasks. Uh-oh, this isn't really... This isn't really
a... Oh, it's Tony Delano.
It's not a narrative. I remember Tony Delano. I don't remember why I remember Tony Delano.
He was the guy, with the smoke, the cigarette machine was talking about at some point.
That's right.
Unit P-20 decommissioned, assigned to scrap for retrieval. So nothing worry.
Currently awaiting orders on something, though, makes it seem...
So he's apparently just assigning these robot repair jobs to people.
So if you are... Wait. He signed that last one to himself.
Yep.
So if you're like a super, super Sherlock sleuth person, does this stuff help you? Like, is this actual information that you can use? Because I'm not going to remember fuck all of it.
I'm not either. Like I said, it's probably mostly not stuff that will help you with something. I know that there is something related to these terminals that you can do. I'm pretty sure that you do not have the necessary perks to pull it off with your character.
All right. Yeah, see, that music right now makes me think that something's important. I don't know, maybe
that's standard background music.
Okay.
Because, you know, it's just a blank.
Facilities director's holotape. We must play the holotape.
Wearing explosive gas. Had two things trying to overrun each other there. Take your military-grade circuit board, though.
Okay, so can we listen to the holotape again?
Yes.
And you not go and get something to attack us this time? See, I missed that. Oh yeah, yes. I'm glad I didn't miss that.
Yeah, I think McDaniel was also the one that was complaining about Delano earlier.
Yep. Yeah, he was. He was.
Okay, we're both on here.
Seriously, though, if you could sleep with Ada, that spinny hand of hers. I am just saying.
Seems like a good place for a...
Abraxo, take the Abraxo. I like chemicals. And drugs.
Uh-huh.
And ball peen hammers.
Drugs.
Drugs!
Ada, you want to open the next
Here.
One for us?
Good job, Ada.
Spinny hands.
Oh, yeah. And it don't stop.
Any of those other things?
Take a silver locket.
No,
I don't need a TV. I don't need a clean black suit. I got a dirty black suit. Okay, I need a clean black suit for it. Just wash the dirty one. Bitches. What's that? It's nothing. Okay.
Oh, it's not nothing. It's a gas canister.
Oh. We probably don't need that right now.
I know they're pretty heavy, so...
Yeah.
Make sure we can still carry stuff around. Whatever we're wanting to get into is not far away over there, but of course this door will not open.
Casual outfit. Take it. I mean, Vel is a badass, but she's still, you know, she's a human woman.
Here we go.
Over here.
The research wing.
Excellent doors. Excellent doors, Mr. Mechanist. This is still Mechanist's.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Another terminal. And back in there.
Ooh. Psycho buff!
Yeah, orange mat. Seems like a Mr. Gutsy model. And a forfeiture terminal password.
Yes!
Ada, I want
to
use this terminal.
Ada, move.
The watch station.
All right. They're offloading another set of subjects to us today. I don't know what these men and women did to deserve being sent here, but since they were transferred from civilian penitentiaries, I can only assume they're the worst society has to offer. I don't think these people have any idea what's about to happen to them. One thing's for sure. These prisoners would have been better off serving their time elsewhere. I'm starting to hear rumors around the block that I don't like. Esteban told me that he overheard two of the eggheads saying that the prisoners are having the brains cut out of their heads, or something like that. I know the brass is running experiments on these inmates, and that they were pretty intense, but I didn't know they were literally cutting them open. I'm not sure how I feel about that. After all, I joined the military because I wanted to serve my country and protect my fellow Americans. I guess I'll keep it to myself for now. Thank you for the footstool. If rumors floating around the block are... I'm sorry. I'm going to start over because I misread the entire first word. That was stupid. The rumors floating around the block are getting worse. One of our informants said that the prisoners are talking about rioting. If the things that they're saying are true, that inmates are getting dissected and the parts used for robots, I almost can't say that I blame them. Esteban said we should go right to Gamma, what is that?
Gamma 4? 9.
9? Sorry.
It's okay.
Wine, y'all. Esteban said we should go right to Gamma 9 status, but I don't want to push the panic button unless I absolutely have to. I've decided to take this all the way to the top and meet with General Rawlings. Criminals or not, these experiments are wrong, and they need to be stopped before it's too late.
Why do I suspect that will not go well for him?
I think it probably won't. Broderick got reassigned out of this facility today. I think they have him scrubbing toilets at some backwater listening post in Anchorage now. They put me in charge of cell block, and I inherited Gamma 9 status.
Initiated.
I'm sorry. And I initiated Gamma 9 status. After 2 days, the threat of rioting is ended, and everything is back to normal. Brass gave me the go-ahead to start sending people to the medical section, and everything is proceeding as planned. If we have any hope of beating the enemy at their own game, we need to get these robots online. Who cares what happens to a few lousy inmates? I told Broderick he needed to fall in line, but he wouldn't listen. Of all people, I would have expected him to understand that the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few.
Yep, didn't go well for Broderick.
Yeah.
Okay. Somewhere that... Oh, wait. It's a password, not a key, so... Ah, there's a terminal. Let's get some light in here.
Through it, round. I kind of need those. Yeah, I need that. Oh, yeah. And I need the Ushanka. I want that too. Yeah, 50 caliber. I don't need summer shorts. I hate shorts.
Okay. All sorts of hard hats.
Then we can come back and get those. Oh, the bowler hat. We already have a bowler hat. We don't have a sea captain's hat. We don't need it. We can come back and get it if we want it.
There's our password.
Nice. Yeah, see, she didn't say it, so I said it.
Ammunition.
Yeah.
Drugs.
I suggest you take as much as we can carry.
You think? Great minds.
Chad, it is almost like we're similar people.
Ordinary submachine gun. We've not taken any ranks in the necessary perks for that.
Gold! Hold it. That was killing me. Yeah. Dang, this was the mother load.
Ordinary pistols.
Wait, what is a can I just look at the stats of the compensated advanced 10mm pistol? Just out of curiosity. Because it is such a fancy name. Show me another pistol that we've got so I can compare.
Okay, there's the compensated advanced.
Yeah.
And...
K. Kellogg's. Just show me Kellogg's.
Well, the Kellogg's is the 44. We, I think, yeah, delivers are the other 10 millimeter we've got.
Okay. So show me compensated advanced skin, please. I mean, that's not a bad pistol, is it?
It's got a slightly higher damage, slightly higher fire rate with the modifications it's got. Advanced is the best receiver for a 10 millimeter pistol. And compensated should be giving it a little better recoil control. It looks like it's got the extended magazine on it.
Are we recording?
Yeah, I started again.
Oh, you started again, okay. Sorry, y'all, I didn't see him start again, I just saw it end. Yeah, let's take that.
Okay, we've got it.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's right, you've got it already.
I'm pretty sure that the deliverer, when we get more mods for it, will be better, but
okay.
It's, The difference at the moment is the deliverer has a suppressor on it, and the other one doesn't.
Wait, what's a suppressor do?
It's a silencer.
Oh.
So it makes it more feasible to shoot somebody and not have all his friends hear it.
Right, gotcha. Yeah, I do actually know what a silencer is.
Research labs and holding block A.
I need new glasses. I could not read that nearly as quickly as you could. What the hell is this?
Oh, it's either the research labs or holding block A.
Well, thank you, Captain Obvious.
I'm betting on holding block A.
I mean, I didn't even mean what is the place. What are those things we're looking at that are... That. What's
we'll
that?
Get closer and find out.
Oh my god, this is horrible.
That's a ghoul. We could unlock that theoretically. Well,
Ada we
could.
Couldn't. Yeah. Oh. Wow. This is.
And there's. Yep, yeah, there's a brain in there.
Were they trying to reanimate that feral ghoul? What's
I
happening
don't think
here?
So. I think maybe that brain came out of that.
Came
feral
out
ghoul.
Of it. Shit.
Because there was taking brains to put in robots.
Excuse me. That burped. Who are we detected by? It didn't say we were in danger.
I suspect that... Yep, some of these are live feral ghouls.
Oh.
But they're locked in cages.
Holy shit.
That one's not dead either.
This is some cold, cold shit right here.
So apparently there was a lot of radiation down here at some point to turn all these prisoners into ghouls.
Yeah. Is that radiation?
That's a circuit breaker we could flip.
Oh.
There's a staircase. There's another level of prisoners, apparently.
Okay, do a quick save, please. Flip the circuit breaker, please.
Okay. Oh, opened all the doors.
See, that's why I had you do a quick save first.
Go get him, Ada.
Yeah, at least these bleed and body parts come off.
Because they go for Ada, we just get them in the back.
Oh, it was just two?
I see more. I saw another. Yep, there's another one. Two out there. At least three. Four? There's quite a few out there.
Holy crap, a bunch of them. We're still alive? Are they alive? They're alive, right?
Yep. Have a grenade, guys. Not sure we got any of them at all. That hurt.
That got I love the sound of eggs.
Looks like we got at least two with that. Okay. Ada, you're supposed to let him take you first. Then we hit him in the back.
I was going to say, they can't do much damage to Ada, can they?
They shouldn't. She's pretty heavily armored.
Yeah.
Matter of fact...
Get him.
Sick him.
Quill.
Thud.
That was easy for her.
Yeah, a bottle cap, and do you want a shot glass?
I always want a shot glass.
Okay, I know you have a shot glass collection.
Yes. In real life, I would have taken the test tube and the fancy hairbrush, but I don't think we probably need it in the game.
Okay. We've got a pile of things over here.
Bottle caps. Yeah, 38 rounds. God, why is he still jittering like that? It's so awful.
There's a button here.
A button
or
push
upstairs.
Quick save and push the button. Oh dear God, what did we just do? Ah.
Oh, we summoned an elevator.
Oh. What's that other light? It will take us somewhere.
Yeah, that would probably activate the elevator.
And there's a brain on there.
Yeah, there's another brain cart.
So get on the elevator.
Okay.
And let's go.
Ada.
Hello, Ada. Come on.
Psst. Here.
All right. Let's go somewhere.
I don't think I can make it there.
What?
Well,
hey, take those bottle caps. Bottle caps. You passed up bottle caps.
Oh.
Thank you.
I didn't search the
bottle. And Wonder Glue.
That's interesting. I just removed our radiation.
Oh.
Convenient. Not that we had much radiation, but...
What? There was a stim pack back there that you just walked right past.
Oh, it's in this locker. Okay.
What is wrong with you? What kind of a looter are you?
Apparently an inefficient one at
times. That is why you need a rogue playing with you.
Go. Search for trays if you ever want one.
Yes.
Very intense.
Oh, they will taste good too.
Yeah, we have two additional flavors now. We have orange and berry on us.
Oh yeah. Hey, what's this?
Ada, trying to look at the X-rays. X-rays.
Okay, I don't know how to read X-rays. Is there anything interesting about them? We're probably not supposed to be able to tell, are we? That's good.
Right behind here. Apparently not. That's broken. Here's one that works.
Yeah.
Brain extraction terminal.
Oh, God. All right, let me see. What's the tone of this? Once again, thanks to equipment failures, we're getting pretty backed up in this department. The brain extractors were never made to operate at this capacity. I think we've been running around the clock for the last few weeks. We usually end up with a popped blade from slicing through a particularly tough skull, or the hydraulics in the pulling arm seize up when the spinal cord isn't fully severed and the brain is pulled too early. I hope that Cirilletti doesn't yell at us again. This really isn't our fault. We all had a pretty good laugh around the extraction department today. Ansel tried mixing some fresh biogel with a little bit of grenadine and vodka and dared us all to drink it down. And it turned out to be pretty good, kind of thick and sweet with just the right amount of kick. We came up with a little game to try and name the drink. A whole bunch of stupid ones came up, of course, but we finally settled on the Extractor Sunrise. Too bad we can't share with the other departments, but the biogel costs like $1,000 a pint, and I don't think Sir Letty would appreciate us drinking down some of her budget. I started that with the wrong tone. Sorry, I had no idea where it was going. Today was Halsey's birthday, so we made him a brain-shaped cake. Well, sort of. We actually just took one of the extracted brains and covered it with frosting. Of course, we didn't tell Halsey that. The look on his face when he bit down on the slice we gave him was pretty hilarious. It was a waste of a decent subject brain, but the prank was totally worth it. We really have some good times down here. I sincerely hope that they don't reassign anyone away from the department. We're working well together, and our efficiency rating can't get much higher. Womack over in sanitation made an offhand comment that his job having to grab what was left of our test subjects and dispose of them in the furnace felt wrong. Then, not a day later, I was sharing lunch with some of the personnel from the assembly division, and they asked me if pulling the brains from our test subjects' heads ever bothered me. I told them it didn't. I'm not sure why some of the people on this project are having problems with what we're doing. Maybe they should look for work somewhere else. That is a cold bitch right there. That was a cold bitch.
Ada, you're constantly in the way.
Okay, Ada is really up there. Ada is the robot version of Stemmel.
Apparently so.
Stemmel is Ted's dog, who is always in the way.
We got lots of robot models in here. What's this? The chief scientist solo.
Well, let's hear that. I'm gonna have to go soon, by the way. Just
okay.
Keep
well,
in
we'll
mind.
Finish the information in here.
Okay.
This is the third time I've had to request more security. As thorough as our assembly procedures may be, there's a human factor to be considered. These are criminal and unstable minds. It can't be a scientist's job to ensure each test subject is properly sedated.
Oh, shit.
I was promised military assistance and security, but we need more. I won't allow my crew to be endangered. As fascinating as it may be to integrate the human mind with robotics, sometimes I wish I never signed on to this project.
Damn. Sometimes. Sometimes I wish I'd never agreed to murder people for the sake of robotics.
Yeah. Stuff in.
Gold watch, gotta take the gold watch. Duct tape and scalpel, yeah, take it all.
And a general recalibration terminal?
Cerebral reconditioning. Oh, God.
Okay, you wanna be Cirilletti and I'll just be the other voice?
Okay, yes. Hello? Can you understand me?
What? Who is that? Where are you? I can't see. My God, what have you people done to me?
Calm down. Calm down.
I can't feel my body. I can't feel anything. What's going on? Please, this is horrible.
A22, if you don't calm down, I'll have to turn you off.
Turn me off? You mean kill me? For the love of God, tell me what the hell you've done.
Terminating A22, subject to unstable. You are designated Unit A-57. Understood?
Yes. A-57, ready to accept commands.
Excellent, A-57. Initiate command Diagnostic Zeta.
Understood.
2 minutes pass with no input. This is taking too long. Please respond.
Error. No command was provided and awaiting unit designation.
Damn it! I think one's short term is shot to hell. Dump it in the furnace. Let's try another. All right. Do you have any memories before your service at this facility?
Negative, ma'am.
Are you certain? Do a deep scan of your memory banks. It's been reported that you're acting irregularly.
Scanning now. Please stand by. Error. Unknown fragment detected. What? This, you can't reveal my arms. My legs, they're gone. What's wrong with me?
Switching off. Aha. There it is. That was quadrant A9878-6756 in the temporal lobe. Can we get a tech in here to clear out the long term and tell them to stop being so sloppy about it? Recording now. Repeat that again.
I said that if you don't put me back in my body, I'm going to kill you, then everyone else in this place.
Interesting. You do realize that you're simply a brain attached to a vocal interface, that you don't have the capability to perform those actions?
I don't care. I'll find a way. And when I do, you'll be the first to die.
Wonderful. Simply wonderful. The lack of your original body doesn't disturb you.
No, it doesn't matter. Whatever it takes, I'll end all of you.
Switching off? Excellent. As soon as we flush the long and short term, this one will be ready. Recommend sending it along to Rawlings. Recommend sending it along to Rawlings' tactical team as soon as it's fitted in a chassis. Well, that was interesting.
That's where we came in over there. Okay. Yeah, those are the x-rays we saw before. These are not.
They are not. What the fuck are we looking at?
Death claw x-rays.
Oh. Oh.
I don't know what that means.
Fuck.
Brain fluid stuff.
Brain fluid stuff.
We got
blood pack.
Radix, dish rag.
No, I don't want
a dish. I didn't think you'd want a dish rag.
Stim pack, if it was.
That's Ada.
No.
Rolling flyer flask.
Not that kind of flask.
Okay. If a hip flask comes along, we'll take that.
Right.
Go this direction, I guess. Oh, I'm gonna save because that's a big space out there.
I got like 5 minutes I need to go.
Okay. Machine gun turret. Scrap bot. Fancy being shot with machine guns. That sure doesn't look like it's nothing.
Excuse me. No, it does not.
Hey, we leveled up.
Woo!
I'm not sure why it's not reacted to the fact that we just blew up stuff right next to it.
Hmm?
Okay.
Something just gub up.
Yeah. Hopefully Ada will slow down the other one. Robot parts that we've already got. Stim pack.
Do we loot all three of those?
Yeah.
You sure?
Maybe not this one.
Yeah, we had 38 round that we didn't get.
Military fatigues, if you want them. At least we've got them anyway.
Adhesive. Yeah. Don't take a paintbrush, we don't need it.
Are we supposed to talk to this one or what?
I think we are. Let's go do it.
It seems to already be deceased.
Do we already have him?
Or inert or something. Well, because it's just letting us loot it.
Well, that's not exactly what we're supposed to be talking to, is it?
Yeah. That's a robo brain, it looks like.
Oh. Well, I mean, loot it. There was stuff you could take.
Yeah.
Take the medical terminal password and the ammo for real.
Yeah, we've got those. Anything back here? Not really. Anything back here? Oh, ammunition.
Mm-hmm. Right away.
Dead person. Long dead person. Morgue?
Yeah.
It would seem. There's where we use that terminal. That's your stopping point?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's
stop here. That's all good. Right. We will proceed into RoboBrain assembly when we return. Thanks, everyone, for listening.
Thanks, everyone, for watching. Listening. Good night.
Good night.